How's it going? It's Friday and we're here again. Been an interesting couple weeks lately. Done two karaoke's and one trivia in a bar. But, as promised, I'm here and it's Friday. All right, trivia will be starting shortly after 7 o'clock. If you need a bucket to play in tonight's game, go outside your house, find a bucket in your backyard, or go get the little garbage can that's in your bathroom, throw out the toilet paper, bring that, and use that as a bucket for tonight's game. Trivia will be starting shortly after 7 o'clock. Apparently, the state has now allowed bars to reopen at 50% capacity, but Jumpin' Jiminy, the county mayor, has decided that we're not going to do that yet. All right, Misfits in the house. Danny in the house. All right, let's get started. I'm assuming there's more people here. This thing is on a delay. It's Friday. After 7 o'clock, and it's time now for home
trivia.
If you don't already have a bucket to play in tonight's game, go outside your house, find a bucket, bring it inside, and use that to play in tonight's trivia game. Right now, we're gonna get started by going over the rules of tonight's game.
It's Friday, you bastards.
All right, so as we've been saying, we need a one-player minimum in order to play, because you need to be at least one person in order to be playing in tonight's trivia game. But please, if you're near people you don't know, please stay 6 feet apart from each other. Grab 3 sheets of paper, number them 1 through 10, or grab one big piece of paper and do 3 columns of 1 through 10. We have 3 rounds, 10 questions each round. That's why you need either 3 papers or 3 columns. And any funny team names you can come up with, put them here in the comments. If I don't see it or don't get to it, I'm not sure. It looks like the feed is catching up now. I'm seeing more or less where I'm by right now. So I think we fixed that problem. But if you do have a funny team name you want to throw this way, I'll read it on here on the live feed. Feel free to scream and shout the answers all you want, because you're at home, I'm at home, and we're just playing for fun. So feel free to scream and shout. Either way, people you're playing against can't hear you. Other than the people you live with who are wondering what the hell you're screaming about. All right, please don't look up the answers. And if you do know the answer, do not post the answers in the comments. Write it on your paper and we'll go over the answers after each round. Don't write it in the comments. As I say, for the first time in 2 months, the cunts have arrived. Oh, the cunts are back. Cunts in the house. As I was saying, don't post the answers, because either way, you're playing with yourself, so you would only be cheating yourself. So there's no point here. There's no prizes. There's no reason to cheat. There's no reason to, you know, show off either. Questions around one are worth 1 point each. 1 point each. Questions around two are worth 2 points each. Questions around three are worth 5 points each. And again, we're home. I have no prizes to give you. So first place is whatever you want to give yourself. Second place, whatever you want to give yourself. But if you want to do me a favor, take a picture of yourself while playing and tag at Trivia Miami and post it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever. Or you can send it to me at TriviaMiami@gmail.com and I'll post it here next week. We'll also be pulling out our stubs and dancing in the Lucky SOB raffle, which here at home means something completely different than what it means over at the bar. All right, here's a legal disclaimer. If you can read small and fast, you can read that thing. And it's gone. And again, despite the fact that I have gotten a couple gigs here and there, you know, spontaneously, I'm still hurting big time. So if you can throw a little bit my way, that would be cool. That's my Venmo. That's my Cash App. I know they say karaoke. Remember, my other line of work is karaoke DJ. I have all my Venmo and Cash App stuff through there, because that's where I would mostly get tips. You know, they don't really tip people in trivia. But if you can tip me here, it would be cool. Now, if you can't tip me here, or you don't want to do that, at least keep telling your friends to join us here every Friday. But even better than that would be if you get out of your house, put a mask on, and join me on Monday over at Bar Nancy. We are doing in-person trivia every Monday. Join me over there. However, the times have changed. It's not 7 to 9. It'll be 8 to 10. I haven't updated the flyer on this game. But the game will now start at 8 o'clock, 8 p.m. every Monday. Join me at Bar Nancy. Here's a picture of how it was set up this time. They have a... I'm still in the same spot, but there's tables are separated very, you know, like that. I check all the papers up there so I don't have to take a table from anybody. There I am, you know, that's me there. We had a good time. We had a good turnout. It would be cool if more people showed up. Our reigning champion did not show up. But these are the winners that we had at Bar Nancy. Second place went to this group. The birthday boy. They were celebrating the birthday in the little area back there. But they did come out and play trivia with us. And first place went to the Maroons. And all of us, including the winners and the losers, all of us enjoyed food from the Cheese Stands Alone, who runs the kitchen at Bar Nancy. So come to Bar Nancy. You can eat there with us, drink with us, and play with us. You get prizes at the end. You can eat. You can drink with your friends. We are practicing all you know, safety guidelines that we need to. And that will be on Monday at 8 o'clock. I know the flyer said 7, but it's 8 o'clock. Also, if you're into karaoke and you miss doing that as well, we're doing another one of these events on Thursday again. We've done two already. We're doing a third one. So if you want to go to karaoke at the Globe in Coral Gables, we're doing it starting at 7 p.m. this time. And you will need a reservation for a table, so you contact the Instagram accounts of at Newly and Friends or at WenoWeno with the underscores as it is on the flyer there. Or you can call the restaurant at their number, 305-445-3555, and, you know, work and set something up with them. They are taking reservations. Once all reservations are taken, nobody else will be allowed to enter. However, if, you know, we don't fill up the reservations, then we will take walk-ins. And if we do fill up the reservations, they're still taking a list of standby people they will call if they see that, you know, the reservations aren't filling up, whatever. All right, let's get started with tonight's game. It's time now to put your phones in the buckets, teléfonos en la cubeta. Phones in the buckets, teléfonos en la cubeta. And another quick disclaimer. This is the exact game I played on Monday. Nobody that comes to this online trivia was there. Not Danny, not Mr. J and the Outlaws. I don't. The Misfits weren't there. I didn't see Alan. I didn't see anybody. I saw new people, Bar Nancy people, a couple of people that I do know, like what used to be the Zika Boys, but they have a new name now. They're changed, but they didn't even get second or third. They were there, but this is the game they played. I'm just repeating the game from Monday completely. I didn't see the point of working any harder for myself this week, considering I had other things to do. But there will be a brand new game on Monday if you want to come play with us there. And if you show up over there, just forces me to work here more. And I don't get paid to do this. I get paid to do that. So I'd rather see you on Monday. But here we go. We're going to start right now with round one. Question one. True or false? The Cannonball Run movies were based on a real coast-to-coast race from the 1970s. True or false? I also got to remember here, it's 35 seconds between questions. At the bar, it's a minute. Listen, you know me, I don't need no introduction, yeah. Everywhere I go, the people love me, yeah. Cause I bring the party in the homies, yeah. Bubbing out, now we ain't lonely, yeah. Heron, makeup. All right, question two. What popular video game recently added Biden-Harris merchandise within the game? What popular video game recently added Biden-Harris merchandise within the game? Question three. Which member of the Bee Gees played no instruments on stage? A. Barry, B. Maurice, or C. Robin? And which member of the Bee Gees played no instruments on stage? Barry, Maurice, or Robin? Have a good time, hit the wall. Red bottom sleigh. Check it in the bag.
DNA, already know my name. Working so hard, trying to maintain. Fell in love with it, now it's my lane. If you think you're coming for me, you are insane. When I love a lot. When I love a lot. When I love a lot. When I level up. When I level up. When I level up.
All right, question four. What is the name of the hero in most of Tom Clancy's novels? What is the name of the hero in most of Tom Clancy's novels? Quick question for those of you in the Grove more often than me. If you drive by or have been anywhere near Sandbar during the weekdays, has there been any movement on construction or renovations? Have you seen those things up and people working in there? Let me know. Because when I ride bike over there on Saturdays, I don't see any movement. But I don't know what's going on. Last I heard, we were supposed to be open by Labor Day. I don't know. All right, question five. What early Fox Network police show launched the career of Johnny Depp? What early Fox Network police show launched the career of Johnny Depp? Question six. What type of creature is a clipspringer? A, an antelope. B, a fish. Or C, an insect. Okay, what type of creature is a clipspringer? Antelope, fish, or insect? Question 7. What animated TV family lived in the SkyPad apartments? What animated TV family lived in the SkyPad apartments? Question 8. What is the name of Bill and Ted's Rock Band? What is the name of Bill and Ted's Rock Band? Question 9. Who is the only former heavyweight boxing champ to be buried in Arlington National Cemetery? A. Joe Frazier. B. Joe Louis. Or C. Rocky Marciano. And who is the only former heavyweight boxing champ to be buried in Arlington National Cemetery? Joe Frazier, Joe Louis, or Rocky Marciano? And finally, everybody's favorite question. Florida! Or not Florida. I'm going to read a news headline. You need to let me know if you think it's Florida or not Florida. The only two possible answers are Florida or not Florida. Here's the headline. Man's big belly saves him from falling down well. Was that Florida or not Florida? That is the end of round one. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question one was, true or false, the Cannonball Run movies were based on a real coast-to-coast race from the 1970s. Question two, what popular video game recently added Biden-Harris merchandise within the game? Question three, which member of the Bee Gees played no instruments on stage? A, Barry, B, Maurice, or C, Robin? Question four, what is the name of the hero in most of Tom Clancy's novels? Five, what early Fox Network police show launched the career of Johnny Depp? Question six, what type of creature is a cliffspringer? A, antelope, B, fish, or C, insect? Question seven, what animated TV family lived in the Skypad apartments? Question eight, what is the name of Bill and Ted's rock band? Question nine, who is the only former heavyweight boxing champ to be buried in Arlington National Cemetery? A, Joe Frazier, B, Joe Louis, or C, Rocky Marciano? And Florida or not Florida, the headline reads, man's big belly saves him from falling down well. All right, please check your own answer sheet. See if these are the answers you want to stick with before we reveal the answers. Again, if there's anything you can do to help me out, it'll be cool. That's my Venmo. That's my Cash App. Let's switch over to our raffle screen. My daughter is there waiting anxiously to give out prizes. She's so happy and smiling. Look at her. She's so excited to be here. We're all in for the U now, as you can tell, us and Baby Yoda. Look, the camera's a little off there. Let's show Baby Yoda there. There he is. He's got a turnover chain. Let's get started with tonight's raffle. All right, it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'm pulling a number out of the bucket I'm going to find right now. This bucket, and every number I pull out, my son will win. My son will win all the prizes. Here we go. First one out. My daughter's up there to give him the prizes, and he will jump in there and start dancing to pick up his prizes. Here we go. 593. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. All right, next one out. Five eight nine. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And now everybody's favorite prize, one free beer, but he's 12 years old. He can't have beer, so he gets an iron beer going out to the following number. 594, dance. All right, he won. You didn't stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. That concludes our lucky son of a Bernie raffle for this round. He still has more tickets. He'll be back after round two and three of tonight's game. All right. Let's go over the answers from round one. Question one was, true or false, the Cannonball Run movies were based on a real coast-to-coast race from the 1970s? That is true. to what popular video game recently added Biden-Harris merchandise within the game? Animal Crossing. 3. Which member of the Bee Gees played no instruments on stage? Robin. 4. What is the name of the hero in most of Tom Clancy's novels? Jack Ryan. 5. What early Fox Network police show launched the career of Johnny Depp? 21 Jump Street. 6. What type of creature is a clipspringer? It is an antelope. 7. What animated TV family lived in the Skypad apartments? The Jetsons. 8. What is the name of Bill and Ted's rock band? Wild Stallions. It doesn't matter how you spelled it. Whatever you, as long as you got Wild Stallions. 9. Who is the only former heavyweight boxing champ to be buried in Arlington National Cemetery? Joe Louis. And Florida or not Florida, the headline read, man's big belly saves him from falling down well. That was not Florida. That happened in China. And obviously, he wasn't happy about it, even though he didn't fall down the well. Oh, well. These questions are worth 1 point each, so whatever you got right, you know, add that together. And post your score in the comments. And I'd like to remind everybody that you can join me on Monday at Bar Nancy. The game is actually not starting at 7, it's starting at 8 o'clock. We're doing it 8 to 10 now that curfew's at 11. And then I'm going to stick around after and play music videos for you guys. So you can join me until we are tired of being there or we get kicked out because of the curfew. But the game will start at 8 o'clock. You can actually win prizes. You get to win the prizes in the raffle. You get to win if you get all the answers right. Not my kids, not me. You guys win. Just come play in person. And if you're thinking, well, what about what I need to eat? Well, remember, the Cheese Stands Alone runs the kitchen over at Bar Nancy. So you can come eat there, drink there, and play there with us Monday night starting at 8 o'clock. If you want to do karaoke on Thursday, you can catch me at the Globe. We're doing another one of these special events. You must contact either on Instagram at Newly and Friends or at Buenabueno to make reservations or call the Globe at 305-445-3555. All right, I'm going to take a quick commercial break, and I'll be back in about 2 minutes.
I love this song. What station is that? Coast, 97.3 FM.
Great song. What station is that? It's Coast, 97.3 FM.
I love this song.
Me too. What station is that?
Ever wonder what radio station you're listening to? For the most music throughout your workday, listen to South Florida's Coast, 97.3 FM. The best mix of the 80s, 90s, and today with less talk.
Grand Prix's new track. Grand Prix is bigger, longer, and faster. Feel the thrill of the hairpin turns, then speed down the long straightaways. Grand Prix. Race your friends in the true spirit of Grand Prix competition racing. Feel the roar of the engines as you race the big challenge on Grand Prix Race-O-Rama. Open 7 days and nights. Take I-95 or Exit 12 on the turnpike. Grand Prix on 441 just south of State Road 84 in Fort Lauderdale.
Take your family, go with your friends to good times where fun never ends. Be there.
The fair!
It's all there. The fair, be there! The fair! Be there!
The Dade County Youth Fair and Exposition. Be there!
Imagine the perfect video store. It would have a great selection, right? Right! Over 10,000 videos. 3 evening rentals, so no rush, no hassle. Fast checkout. 24-hour quick drop return. Open late every night. Well, the perfect video store.
Welcome to Blockbuster Video.
Is popping up all over the country. There's one near you.
Blockbuster Video. Wow, what a difference.
And we're back. Let's see what we got going here. 10 points, 10 points, 9 points, 8 points. I guess that's all the teams? Whatever. There's 14 people watching at least, from what I see. Oh well. Let's get started. Round 2 is time again. Put your phones in the buckets, teléfonos en la cubeta. Round 2. Question 1. What came out first, The Rundown or Walking Tall, both with Dwayne The Rock Johnson? I was also all in for the U. And what came out first, The Rundown or Walking Tall, both with Dwayne The Rock Johnson? Question two. What classic TV sitcom opens with the theme, making our dreams come true? What classic TV sitcom opens with the theme, making our dreams come true? Question three. Singer-songwriter Elle King is the daughter of what former SNL cast member? Singer-songwriter Elle King is the daughter of what former SNL cast member? Elle King is the one that sings X's and O's. Question four. It's time now for our anal bum cover. Sorry, an album cover. Whose 1996 album is this the cover for? Just the name of the artist, not the name of the album. Whose 1996 album is that the cover for? Question five. What two countries co-hosted the FIFA World Cup in men's soccer in 2002? What two countries co-hosted the FIFA World Cup in men's soccer in 2002? Question six is always our movie clips. I'm going to play a clip from a movie that was released in 1993. If you know what it is, write it down. I'll play once with just the sound and once with the words up on the screen. This one's short, so listen closely.
I know I'm pretty, but I ain't as pretty as a couple of titties.
One more time.
I know I'm pretty, but I ain't as pretty as a couple of titties.
What movie is that from? Write it down. All right, question seven. What is Ozzy Osbourne's real first name? What is Ozzy Osbourne's real first name? Question 8. The 2005 documentary film The Smartest Guys in the Room was about what troubled U.S. corporation? And the 2005 documentary film The Smartest Guys in the Room was about what troubled U.S. corporation? Question 9. Actress Carrie Fisher and singer Edie Brickell have both been married to what musician? Actress Carrie Fisher and singer Edie Brickell have both been married to what musician? Finally, question 10, last question this round. What jewelry company makes the Vince Lombardi Trophy? What jewelry company makes the Vince Lombardi Trophy? That is the end of round two. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question was, what came out first, The Rundown or Walking Tall, both with Dwayne The Rock Johnson? Question two, what classic TV sitcom opens with the theme Making Our Dreams Come True? Question three, singer-songwriter Elle King is the daughter of what former SNL cast member? Anal Bump Cover, whose 1996 album is this the cover for? Just the name of the artist, not the name of the album. Question 5. What two countries co-hosted the FIFA World Cup in men's soccer in 2002? Movie clip from 1993.
I know I'm pretty, but I ain't as pretty as a couple of titties.
What movie is that from? Question 7. What is Ozzy Osbourne's real first name? And in the 2005 documentary film, The Smartest Guys in the Room was about what troubled U.S. corporation? 9. Actress Carrie Fisher and singer Edie Brickell have both been married to what musician? Question 10. What jewelry company makes the Vince Lombardi Trophy? All right, please check your own answer sheet. See if these are the answers you want to stick with. Again, any little bit helps. You want to help me out, hook me up. Those are my things, my Venmo, my Cash App, at Karaoke Miami and Venmo, the dollar sign Karaoke Miami and Cash App. If you want to hook me up, that's cool. I mean, any little bit helps. I mean, I'm doing as best I can with what little opportunities I'm given, but it's still not enough. And plus, you know, I got to educate these kids. I got to pay for this internet. I mean, they got rid of that platform that fucked them up at the beginning, but they're finally sitting here working on school this week. Now they're really angry at me because they actually got to do some homework. So let's move on to the raffle. My daughter's up there playing with the prizes, and my son is waiting on the side to win them. And let's get started. it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'm pulling a number out of this bucket, and any number I pull out, my son wins. My son will win all the prizes. All right, let's get out the first number. My daughter is up there waiting to give the prizes to my son. I guess the first one will be the big chain. Going out to the following number. 592-592. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't say it with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. All right, next one out. 570-570. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't say it with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. Wait for the good part. That's Bar Nancy. Monday. Join me there. And finally, everybody's favorite prize, one free beer. One free beer, but he can't drink beer. He can only drink iron beer. I don't know where the iron beer is, but he has it somewhere. Going out to the following number. 590-590. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't say with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. That's who the lucky son of a Bernie raffle for this round. He'll be back after round three. Now let's go over the answers from round two. Question one was, what came out first, The Rundown or Walking Tall, both with Dwayne The Rock Johnson? It was The Rundown. To what classic TV sitcom opens with the theme, Making Our Dreams Come True? Laverne and Shirley. Number three, singer-songwriter Elle King is the daughter of what former SNL cast member? She's the daughter of Rob Schneider. I found that out by watching Jimmy Kimmel Live. And David Spade was hosting, and he brought it up. And I wrote it down to make it a trivia question, and I was going to use it a couple weeks ago. But then they called me to do Bar Nancy, and I said, well, I'm saving that for them. Because that's a paying gig. But now it's back here again because I mentioned at the beginning, we're just playing a repeat of all the questions you would have had on Monday. You had last Monday if you would have been there. All right, I Ain't No Bum Cover. Whose 1996 album is this the cover for? Weezer. And five, what two countries co-hosted the FIFA World Cup in men's soccer in 2002? South Korea and Japan. 1993 movie was?
I know I'm pretty, but I ain't as pretty as a couple of titties.
True Romance. So what is Ozzy Osbourne's real first name? John. Just John. Question 8. In the 2005 documentary film, The Smartest Guys in the Room was about what troubled U.S. corporation? Enron. With nine, actress Carrie Fisher and singer Edie Brickell have both been married to what musician? Paul Simon. And question 10, what jewelry company makes the Vince Lombardi trophy? Tiffany & Company. All right, these questions are worth 2 points each, so whatever you got right times two, add that to your previous score, and that'll give you a running total at this point. And once you have that, post your score in the comments so you can argue between each other about who's got what right and who's cheating. I'd like to remind everybody that you don't have to check your own papers on Monday because you can come play in person and I'll check the papers for you. And you can actually win real prizes. You can win prizes in the raffle. You can win prizes at the end of the game. Whatever you're doing at this point is what your score would have been at this point on Monday. Again, start time on the flyer says 7, but it's not going to be 7. It's 8 o'clock, 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. And then I stick around afterwards and play music videos for you guys so you can, you know, have a night of fun there, eat, drink. You know, all the festivities, and if, like I said, you can eat there. Food is provided by the Cheese Stands Alone, who runs the kitchen over at Bar Nancy. Also, if you're interested in karaoke, karaoke is over at the Globe on Thursday for another one of these special events. We're doing the third one this week. You need to reserve a table in order to be there, so contact either at Newly and Friends or at Buena Bueno on Instagram. Those are their things with the underscores, and, you know, Just follow that. Find the links on my Karaoke Miami page, or you can call 305-445-3555 for more information. All right, I'm going to take another quick commercial break, and I'll be back in about 2 minutes.
If you're hungry and in the mood for something extraordinary, look for this symbol. And this telephone is the fastest way to Franco's original Italian pizza day or night. If you live anywhere from Pompano to Hialeah, you can treat yourself to the best in authentic Italian dishes. Franco's specializes in dishes from antipasto to veal francese, all at reasonable prices. This symbol of excellence is in Pompano, Fort Lauderdale, North Miami Beach, North Miami, and Hialeah. Franco's, the king of pizza with home delivery day or night.
97 GTR, continuous rock and roll with Herman and McBean Mornings.
No more pop scratches and ugly black buildup for these rock and roll animals. Whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa. 97 GTR, all compact disc rock and roll.
Like ZZ Top, Bruce Springsteen, we the Rolling Stones. Herman and McBean Mornings on 97 GTR, continuous rock and roll.
Ay, bendito, se le paró el carro. ¿Y eso cómo fue?
No sé. Yo le había echado coolant, pero se calentó.
Mire, lo voy a ayudar, porque yo tengo un tremendo coolant. Amali. La próxima vez échele a Amali. Este sí es un coolant de calidad superior. Porque todos los coolant no son iguales, ¿sabes? Amali es mejor de lo que tiene que ser.
Ah, pero oiga, ¿usted no es irichaco?
Sí, y de coolant, yo sí sé. Exija a Amali. Tremendo coolant.
Why settle for some of it when you can get all of it?
Get it all, get to Zehr, and get it all.
It's gotta be a knockout, so I got to Zehr.
It's gotta last.
It's gotta have a name I know.
So we got to Zehr.
Get it all,
it's gotta be a real value.
Get to Zehr, and get it all.
Exciting fashions, famous brands, honest quality, genuine value.
Get to Zehr, and get it all.
From Miami. Se llama Zaire. All right, and we're back. So we are at this point. So far, from what I see, 26, 21, 21, 23. Well, that's what your scores would have been at this point in the game on Monday, while you would have been drinking and eating with your friends in person. But let's go on now to round three. It's time again to put your phones in the buckets, telephones en la cubeta. Phones in the buckets, everybody. All right, let's get started. Round three, question one. Born into a family of Dutch Americans, who was the only U.S. president to speak English as a second language? Okay, born into a family of Dutch Americans, who was the only U.S. president to speak English as a second language? All right, question two. Hey, the penny farthing, also known as a high wheel, was the first machine to be called a what? The penny farthing, not a penny farting, also known as a high wheel, was the first machine to be called a what? Not to be mixed up with the penny farting. Penny farting is a Miguel. Miguel's farting pennies, quarters, nickels, dimes, dollars, all kinds of denominations. Question three. It's time now to name celebrity. I'm going to put a picture of celebrity up there. If you know who it is, write down their real name, not a character name, not a description. We've seen them.
Name this celebrity.
I need his real name, not a character name, not a description. Where you seen him?
in circles with you on a daily. We used to sit up blowing circles, getting faded. Now we sit distant, feelings intertwined, trying to make sense of where we are this time.
I don't like it when we're up, down, up, down. When we're up, down, up, down.
All right, question four. In what part of the body would you find Cowper's fluid? In what part of the body would you find Cowper's fluid?
Let's wait and see. Only time can tell what's meant for us. We can't rush
like
anything.
It when we're up, down, up, down. When we're up, down, up, down.
Sometimes I wonder how we got so high. Let's take it easy and not get lost this time.
Don't take me up, down, won't you come?
All right, it's time now for question five, which is always our... Jumble.
Jumble.
Six on the top, seven on the bottom. There's our C-O-R-N, B-E-E-R-P-A-I-N-S. Hint, it's an actor, male. Corn beer pains. Figure it out. All right, hopefully you've either figured this out or wrote this information down somewhere on your piece on a piece of paper so you can keep working on it. I am moving on to question six. The Goddard, or however you say it, Goddard Base Tunnel, which opened on June 1st, 2016, is located in which country? The Goddard Base Tunnel, which opened on June 1st, 2016, is located in which country? Question seven. Who is the only player in Major League Baseball history to win a batting title in three different decades? Who is the only player in Major League Baseball history to win a batting title in three different decades? Question 8. Which U.S. President's wife was the first lady to hold a graduate degree? Which U.S. President's wife was the first lady to hold a graduate degree?
Say you know the truth. You You see it through your green eyes. It's calling you. It's calling you. The summer days are over.
All right, question 9. What disease was once nicknamed the Great White Plague? I mean, what disease was once nicknamed the Great White Plague? Question 10. And last question of tonight's game, something of local history, news, or facts. What local tourist attraction is suing Epic Games, the makers of Fortnite? What local tourist attraction is suing Epic Games, the makers of Fortnite? That is the end of round 3. Let's go over the questions one more time in case you missed any. Question 1 was, born into a family of Dutch Americans, who was the only U.S. president to speak English as a second language? Question 2, the penny farthing, not penny farting, also known as the high wheel, was the first machine to be called what? To name this celebrity and his real name, not a character name, not a description where you've seen him. Question 4, in what part of the body would you find Cowper's fluid? Word jumble, 6 on the top, 7 on the bottom. Those are the letters. Since an actor male, corn beer pains. 6, the Collar Base Tunnel, which opened on June 1st, 2016, is located in which country? 7, who is the only player in Major League Baseball history to win a batting title in 3 different decades? 8, which U.S. president's wife was the first lady to hold a graduate degree? 9, what disease was once nicknamed the Great White Plague? Question 10, local history, news, or facts. What local tourist attraction is suing Epic Games, the makers of Fortnite? All right, please check your own answer sheet. See if these are the answers you want to stick with. Again, if you want to hook it up, hook it up. That's my Venmo. That's my Cash App. These kids need to be educated and fed. So if you want to throw something my way, it would be really cool. I know you've seen that I've been getting some gigs here and there. Those are not permanent gigs. Those are occasional gigs. Well, except Bar Nancy. Bar Nancy is going to be every Monday. So join me on Monday at Bar Nancy. Bar Nancy, Monday, 8 p.m. That is where trivia will be. Whole new game on Monday. All right, let's get over to the raffle portion. My daughter is up there with her cat waiting to give out prizes to my son, who is somewhere on the side here. And let's get started with our third and final raffle. All right, it's time to pull out your stubs. It's raffle time. I'm going to pull a number out of this bucket, and any number I pull out, my son will win. My son will win all the prizes. See what he gets first. The one that flew up. 575, 575. Dance. All right, he won. You didn't. Stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. All right, next one out. Five seven six, dance. All right, he won. You didn't. Stay with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. And finally, everybody's favorite prize: one free beer. But like I said, he can't get beer. He gets an iron beer, and he's not getting a cat. That's for sure. She won't give the cat to anybody, even though the cat likes me better. He does. She does. We think it's a girl. We don't know. If anybody can help us figure out what it is, we can open her legs and put it right in front of the camera for you, and you can just tell me. No, she won't let me do that. 595-595. Dance. All right. He won. You didn't. Say it with me. You lucky son of a Bernie. Not good, the lucky son of a Bernie Raffle for tonight's game.
Like a Hialeah is a thing to do. Every time you go, you learn something new. Opa-laka, Hialeah. Opa-laka, Hialeah is a thing with me.
I'm going to make that song into a karaoke song. Mark my words, before the end of the year, the Opa-laka, Hialeah song will be a selection in my karaoke library. And I will be the only person in the world who has it. All right, before we go on to the answer portion, I'd like to hold your attention and bring you to tonight's chug-off. I want to play what would be a classic chug-off, but it actually is the very last chug-off we had. Very last chug-off we had at Sandbar before everything went to shit. I realized that I was still holding on to that video. I never posted it. I never edited it. I just freaked out and just went straight to doing online trivia. And didn't even think to go to whatever I had left in the camera. But here is the final chug-off we ever did before they closed everything down.
All right. Each one of you, grab your beers. When I say go, you can chug those beers as fast as you can without spilling. First one, put the empty cup on the counter with you. You can't stop and breathe in the middle. You drink it all the way down and put the cup down. One, two, go!
And that was our very last chug-off before everything went to hell. All right, let's go over the answers from round three. Which one was born into a family of Dutch Americans? Who was the only U.S. president to speak English as a second language? Martin Van Buren. The penny farthing, also known as a high wheel, was the first machine to be called a what? A bicycle. I've been riding a lot of bike. I've become obsessed. All right, ask your name. This celebrity, that is David Arquette. In what part of the body would you find Cowper's fluid? In the penis. And don't look it up. I looked up an image for this to put the answer for slide, and I regret that still, and I'm still traumatized by what it showed me. So I just went with the eggplant. That was the safest way to give you this answer. Don't look it up. Trust me. Don't look up Cowper's fluid in an image search. All right, question five. Word jumbo. Six on the top, seven on the bottom. Those are the letters. It is. Joe, I know you were working on the word jumbo and you just got it, but sorry, you know, it's already too late. Go back to running for president. We need you to win. Go back to doing that. Forget about the word jumbo. The answer actually is Pierce Brosnan. For six, the Goddard Base Tunnel, which opened on June 1st, 2016, is located in which country? In Switzerland. For seven, who is the only player in Major League Baseball history to win a batting title in three different decades? George Brett. Question eight, which U.S. president's wife was the first lady to hold a graduate degree? Pat Nixon. Question eight, what disease was once nicknamed the Great White Plague? No, that's not it, even though I saw somebody who had the same joke I did. That's not it. That is not great in any way. That's just a shitty plague. No, the Great White Plague was tuberculosis. And question 10, local history, news, or facts. What local tourist attraction is suing Epic Games, the makers of Fortnite? It is Coral Castle. All right, these questions are worth 5 points each, so whatever you got right times five, add that to your previous score. That'll give you a total at this point. And post your score in the comments. Argue between each other. I also like to remind you that you can play this very game in person over at Bar Nancy. Not this game. There will be new questions on Monday. The game starts at 8 p.m. I didn't update the flyer. I was in a hurry. It starts 8 p.m. We're doing 8 to 10, and then I'm playing music videos until they close. So join me Monday, 8 to 10. Play for fun and prizes. You win the raffle prizes. You win the prizes if you get the answers right. And if you want to eat there, which I suggest you do, they got great food from the Cheese Standalone. So you can eat and drink and play with me on Monday in person, not online, in person at Bar Nancy in Little Havana. And if you're interested in going to karaoke, go to the Globe. Contact them at those Instagram accounts, at Newly and Friends or at When I Went, to make reservations. Once all tables are full, they were not going to take anybody else. Or you can call them at 305-445-3555 to reserve a table for Thursday night. We're going to start it at 7 p.m. this time, not 6 p.m., because obviously curfew got moved an hour later, so we're going to start things a little bit more at a more reasonable hour now. All right, I'm going to take one more commercial break to give you guys enough time to post your scores, and I'll be back to say goodnight.
You know why I come to Lum's, good buddy? They grill the steaks just perfect. And the fish fry dinner is so tender and delicious. I love the juicy roast beef sandwich piled high with that thinly sliced roast beef. I like it when Mommy and Daddy take me to Lum's. The burgers are great. You and your kids get a better choice when you choose Lum's.
You get a choice. You get a better choice when you choose Lum's.
Compact disc sale of the year. Thousands of titles for only $8.99. All types of music. Rock, country, soul, jazz, classical, vocal, big band, pop. Hundreds of artists. Something for everyone. CDs for only $8.99. Come into Peaches now while the best selection's available.
This is the new baby in our family. A baby doll. A famous doll. Archie Bunker's grandson, Joey Stivick. So, of course, he's special. Your child can give him a drink from his bottle, then he wets. And when his diaper is changed, it's clear that Joey Stivick is a physically correct boy doll. My husband and I think that's terrific. And he's such a soft and cuddly doll.
Archie Bunker's grandson, Joey Stivick, by Ideal, is a physically correct boy doll.
What a great idea.
What a great idea. All right. I'd like to thank everybody for joining us. Again, you're all winners as far as I'm concerned. And if you wanted to know how it actually the scores went, anybody who got more than 42 points would have won on Monday. Let's just say that. I see Robinson 53. Danny got 46. The Cunts got 46. The winning team got 42. On Mondays, so you easily could have gotten a $50 bar tab on Monday if you would have been there. So thanks again for watching us. You remember you can follow us at Trivia Mammy on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Also, you can search on for Trivia Mammy on YouTube. You can watch this entire game plus all the previous games. All 26 games that we've done online are there. Well, 25 plus this one. And all information is also on my website at TriviaMiami.com. As we like to say up in the bend,
fuck Hector.
And everybody at the bend likes to say together,
fuck Hector!
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 No ha habido ni papel de trole para limpiarse el culo.
Again, any little bit helps. You want to help me out, that's my Venmo, that's my Cash App. Again, you know, we're struggling, we're all struggling, so if you can, you can. You can't, you can't. But, you know, if you can't and you still want to play, come join me Monday at Bar Nancy. As I mentioned, we'll be there Monday starting at 8 o'clock, not 7 o'clock. Flyer has to be updated. We were shifted all the times due to the curfew change. So it'll be trivia Mondays at 8 p.m., 8 to 10, and then music videos until closing. Play for fun, play for prizes. You win the prizes in the raffle, and stay there and eat with the Cheese Standalone. If you like karaoke, come join me at the Globe. Contact them to make reservations. Those are the links right there, Newly and Friends and Bueno Bueno, or call them at their number. All right, everybody. Thanks again for joining us. I'd like to thank everybody again every week. I'll be here next Friday as well, unless I get work, but I doubt it. So I'll be here next Friday as well. And if, like I said, come see me on Monday. Monday. Come see me Monday for an entirely new game where you can win for prizes at Bar Nancy. Get your teams together. Come join me Monday at Bar Nancy. All right, I'm going to let Cox on the Radio sign us off. Thanks, everybody. Good night.
Have yourself a real nice day. And if you want to smile some, listen to Power 96.